Hi guys, and welcome back in MedicalScribe. This video is the third video in the Introduction to Anatomy series. And today we will talk about how we will study the internal structures of the human body. In the original anatomy approach, and in order to study the internal and deep structures of the human body, we have three main methods. The first one is by dissection, which means that we will dissect the human body by a scalpel and visualize these structures. While the second method is by radiographic and sectional imaging, which is the X-ray, CT scan, MRI, and others. While the third method is by endoscopic technique, and soon we will know that what each one of these methods mean. Regarding the first method, which is the dissection, it will serve us in some points, while it will not in others. What I mean that this method will be applicable if the person is dead, and it will make us understanding the internal structures very well. But if the person is alive, we can't use this method, of course. That means it will definitely provide us a very good way to understand the internal structures, but it won't be out of difficulties. And in fact, a lot of universities now set their sight at the anatomical simulators that we use it in our modern devices. Right? Good. While the second method is the radiographic and the sectional imaging, we will use it if either the person was alive or dead. And it also can be used if the internal structures are normal or if it's damaged. So, if these internal structures were normal, we will call the radiographic and sectional imaging technique here as the radiographic anatomy. This radiographic anatomy will provide us a useful information about the normal structures in a living individual, demonstrating the effect of muscle tone, body fluids, and many others. While if these structures were damaged, we will call the radiographic and sectional imaging technique here as the diagnostic radiology. This diagnostic radiology will reveal the effects of a trauma, pathology, and aging on the normal structures of the body. Now we will talk about the last method we have, which is the endoscopic techniques. Here we will use a flexible fiber optic device that we will insert it into either one of the body's orifices or by making a small surgical incision, which called the portal. Then we will insert this device through it to examine the internal structures, such as the interior of the stomach. Here, in these techniques, the computer devices will help us a lot, because you know there will be a small camera in the endoscopy device that will display a video on a screen by the computer. So these are the main methods in studying the internal structures of the human body in the original anatomy approach. And every method has a lot of details that I will explain it later in another videos. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video and goodbye.